name is Clara McKinnis. I am a second semester junior at MTSU, and I'm currently living in Washington, D.C., doing an internship at the Embassy of El Salvador through a program called the Washington Center, or TWC. And I'm going to be taking you all along with my day today. I already got ready. Hair and makeup is done. I'm dressed. I'm about to go pack my lunch, and then we will be out the door to catch the metro. But today is a pretty exciting day for me. We get to see some of that a little bit later. But I'm going to go pack my lunch, and then you all get to see my commute to the train station. So I'll talk to you in a little bit. Okay, so my lunch is packed. I have my backpack. I wanted to show you all, this is my building. It says the Washington Center on it. But I'm about to walk to the train, and I will tell you all a little bit more about myself. So let's go. Okay, so I'm walking to the train. Thankfully, it's only about 5 minutes from my apartment, which is nice. And I get to walk through this cute little neighborhood. But I am a second semester junior, so I'm graduating December 2023. I'm a double major, double minor. My majors are international relations and Spanish, and my minors are psychology and global studies. So this is my desk. My supervisor gave me this Harry Styles magazine and a movie poster, but I have my computer and my notebooks. They gave me this notebook on my first day as a little present, and then I use the back of this notebook to write all of the new Spanish words that I learned, and my planner, of course. And this morning somebody wrote in semita, which is like a El Salvadoran coffee cake. It's like eating it breakfast, so someone brings it in probably once a week. I took a bite out of it. It's super good. I love having it with my iced coffee. But that's my breakfast this morning. Okay, so I just had my morning meeting with my boss. I do a news briefing every morning for him about the news in El Salvador, the U.S., and anything big in the world that happens. And then we talk about what we have planned today, so what meetings we have, what I'm working on, what projects he's working on, so we're on the same page. And so my big project right now is I'm going through the census information and figuring out where the largest populations of El Salvadoran immigrants are in the U.S. and then figuring out who their congresspeople are so we can reach out to them. I also wanted to show you all this. The first week I was here, they gave me this snack pack. This brand, Diana, is like the big snack company in El Salvador. I've already eaten most of it, but the two things that I have left, these are like Cheetos, basically. And then these are just little chips. They're kind of just like crunchy, salty, but these are super good. I'm gonna have to figure out where I can find these when I get back to Murfreesboro, and the semita. I'm gonna need some of that when I get back to Tennessee, but yeah. Okay, so I am outside eating lunch. I try to eat out here every day if I can. It's a nice little break from being in the office all day, and I usually get pretty cold inside, so I like to come out here and warm back up. I've just been working on projects. When I go back inside, I'll keep working on those projects. One of the exciting things that's happening tonight is my boyfriend is coming to visit from Tennessee. He should be here in about 3 hours. He's coming to the embassy, and he's going to meet everyone that I work with. I'm going to give him a little tour around the office, show him where I've been working for the past month. So I'm super excited about that. Okay, so I just left work. My boyfriend showed up.
I'm Nathan Blair. I'm also a student. I'm a junior at MTSU studying pro pilot.
Yeah. So we just left the office, he got to meet everyone, speak a little bit of Spanish, and then...
Bye!
Bye! So the other exciting thing we have tonight is we are going to the former residence of the Ambassador of Spain for a film series. For the past 2 or 3 weeks, all of the Hispanic embassies in D.C. have been showing films from their country at their embassies, and so we are going to one tonight at the residents of Spain. But yeah, so I'll just take you all along to that, and we're about to leave to head that way. So we finally found a place to park. If you ever come to DC, do not drive your car. It's not worth it. Just take the subway. It took us, 15 minutes to find a place to park. The event starts in 20 minutes, so we're gonna head that way, and I will show you all what it's like when we get there. Okay, so we made it to where the movie is being shown. We are at the former residence of the Ambassador of Spain. There's the Spanish flag. And we're about to go inside and get our seats and watch the movie. So
I will show you all the inside in just a minute. Okay, so we made it inside. This place is beautiful. I can't believe that people used to live here. I mean, they were ambassadors, but it's like a museum, basically. So nobody lives here anymore, but the Embassy of Spain still uses this space for like art exhibitions, as you can see, showing movies like tonight, any party or networking event that they have, they do it here. So this is a really cool space with a lot of history behind it. And I can't wait to watch the movie that they're showing. It's all in Spanish, so hopefully I'll be able to understand the majority of it. Nathan probably won't understand a whole lot of it. He's excited though. But we're super excited to be here, so I'll let y'all know how it goes. Okay, so we just got out of the movie. It was kind of sad, but it was really good. Right now we are just walking around the house. They have this beautiful garden outside, so we're just walking through it. I spoke with a couple of people from the embassy, gave them my card. Have to network all the time in this career, but we're about to go get some pizza. Nathan is starving, so we're gonna go eat dinner. Okay, so we just finished dinner. We ate pizza at this place called Duccini's Pizza. It's in Adams Morgan, Washington, D.C. If you ever come here, check out Adams Morgan. It's a super cute area. There's tons of restaurants, tons of little shops, very walkable. But we are headed back to the car right now. Like I said, when you come to D.C., don't ever bring your car. It's not worth it. We're gonna head back to my apartment and I'll do an apartment tour when I get back. I'm not sure what we're doing for the rest of the night. Probably going to bed because it's been a long day, but I'll show you all my apartment when we get back. Okay, so I'm back at my apartment now. This is my room. We are right across from the elevators, so I'm gonna take y'all inside now. So we walk in and this is our kitchen. This is our living room. These are my roommates. They're from the University of Michigan. This is their room. And then this is my room and my roommate. She also goes to MTSU. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Elizabeth.
She's also a second semester junior majoring in
forensic science.
And where do you work?
At the Department of Forensic Science.
Of course. But this is our room. Our apartment's pretty small, but she's nice and we love her, so. Okay, so we ended up making a stop at a crepe store. This is our last trip for the day. I got a strawberry and Nutella crepe. I've never had a crepe before, so I'm really excited to try it. I actually ordered in Spanish. The employees here spoke Spanish, but I decided to just go ahead and do it in Spanish. I gotta practice whenever I can. But I got my crepe, about to try it, and then we're gonna go back to my apartment and call it a night.
But I'm probably going to be signing off here. So thank y'all for following along with my day. I hope that you enjoy getting to see what I get to do, my commute to work, my job, all the fun stuff I get to do with the embassy. But that is my day in Washington, D.C. If you ever get a chance, definitely visit. Definitely pick up on a little bit of Spanish before you come. A lot of people here speak Spanish. But hope you'll have a good rest of your day. Bye.